agility ladder. So what you'll notice right now is that I actually don't have an agility ladder out. I'm not a huge fan of the ladders, so I don't use them. Also, when we call it an agility ladder, we're not really working on agility. What we're working on is positioning and body positioning, foot speed, and footwork. So agility ladder is a great drill, but understand what you're trying to get out of it. It's not a true agility drill where you're cutting and changing direction. You're really just working on the foot speed and footwork, preparing for those cuts. So think about it as, again, as ground reaction force. How fast can you get in and out of the ground? This is not only going to transfer to cutting, but understanding and building those pathways to help you jump, to help you run quicker, so you can learn to anticipate the ground and fire those muscles faster and be more explosive. So with this, we just need to talk about body positioning and then kind of what I'm looking for. So we're going to be in our athletic stance on all of these. So most of you have done an agility ladder before. You've done achy shuffle and achy two or two in, two out, all those. And we're going to cover those quickly, but I want to talk about what you really should be looking for when you're doing this. So the athletic position, again, we're just going to be on the balls of our feet. Our knees are bent, hips are back, our weight's over our toes. So we got that rod from our ear through our hips, and we're really pretty low here. Also, what I like to do is have two bands. So you saw those in the video right before this. You saw the bands around my knees, the mini bands, and the bands around my ankles. What that's gonna do is force us to get our feet directly under our shoulders and force us to really work our hips. So we don't want those bands to allow us to collapse. We want those bands to force us to be out in a good athletic position, and then we're really working hips here. Okay, I love that, the ability to work hips on this and footwork and foot speed and all that stuff. So athletic position, and when you're in that position, think about, okay, those bands are gonna be forcing me out. And now from here, if I were to do like an achy shuffle, what I wanna think about is not making it a really wide drill. So that's why I don't like the ladder. The ladder makes us go one, two, three, and then back in here. Even if we make it smaller, it's still pretty big. If I were to run at you and make a cut, it's gonna be real quick like that. So my feet are in, I sink, and whatever I do in whatever direction I choose to go, my feet are really quick and really small. So we're gonna think about being on kind of like a cliff of both sides of us, keeping it really small. We're also gonna try and get as many reps as we can in if I were to move forward like agility ladder would. Rather than having a foot square, we're gonna get as many reps as we can in working on that footwork. So don't think about making it really big and going that big. We wanna keep it small from a width and small from how fast we get down the ladder or how fast we get down the next 20, 30 feet. So think about, as we go in and we talk about icky shuffle, icky two, I'm gonna go over a couple of those, but really, I'm telling my athletes to go as fast as they can on these, and if they're not messing up, they're probably not going fast enough. So they start slow. So if we're doing an icky shuffle, what an icky shuffle would be one, two, three, they lift the foot up, they go back the other way. One, two, three, one, two, three, and they start working that faster. What I want them is to start slow, build it faster, 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 and then if they mess up, they just reset, start a little bit slower again, and we're gonna go about 20, 25 feet down the way with this until we stop and turn around, just about the length of an agility ladder also. But if they gotta stop multiple times, reset, and work that speed up, that's really what I'm looking for. So icky shuffle, remember that one, two, three, one, two, three. You also notice my arms are just gonna kinda tempo. So the faster my feet go, my arms are tempoing, that's coming from my shoulders. If I do icky two, one, two, three, one, two, three, touch. One, two, three, touch. One, two, three, touch. So we're getting one, two, three, and 2 feet out. One, two, three, and 2 feet out. So that's what, those are the two usually hardest drills that we're gonna work on our agility ladder. Other than that, we may be working like an ollie shuffle. We gotta focus on, with those, all of those drills, keeping our hips square. So we don't wanna be opening like this. We just wanna keep our hips square and make sure we're moving linear down the field. So really the rest of them, we're just gonna review on those videos of what we did, show them what they are, but think about foot speed, think about footwork, and now with those bands, those mini bands around your knees and around your ankles, that's gonna really start to burn the glute med, the side of your hip, and force you to have your knees and have good athletic position, have your shoulders over your knees over your hips, prepared for really anything coming at you. And that's what you're trying to do when you're working any performance enhancement, is work harder than you may have to on the field or on the court. So great drill, work that footwork, work that foot speed, and really go as fast as you can until you mess up. If you can get some mini bands, that's gonna be an awesome addition to what you're really trying to do, and start working that strength of the hip so we don't externally rotate, we keep those toes pointed forward. One more tip on this. So when we're down in our athletic position, we gotta make sure that we're pointing our toes exactly forward. A lot of coaches may teach you to open your hip here and either land even on your toe or your heel, which isn't really a powerful or a good athletic position. When we make a cut, we're gonna bring our hips with us and stay on the ball of our foot so we're prepared where we need to go next. So when you're using the mini bands and they're around your ankles and around your knees, they're gonna be trying to push you in and you're just gonna wanna kinda slide that. We don't wanna do that. We wanna lift and push. So we wanna lift that foot off the ground and force ourselves to really try and keep that toe forward and be in a good athletic position so we're prepared for our next move, whether that's running, cutting, or jumping, but in the agility ladder, just prepared for that next step, not letting the band dictate what we do and making sure we're in a good athletic stance.